从前有座山，山里头有座庙，庙里有个老和尚讲故事。他讲的是什么呢？功夫是个啥？传说有绝学，深山藏秘籍，觅得一神兵，逍遥闯江湖，仗义行天下。
A weapon is an extension of the human body. All Kung Fu practitioners want to find the ideal weapon. After being forged in the fire, a weapon is further shaped by the physiology and psychology of its owner until it becomes an integral part of his life. The world is like a furnace. As we forge weapons, we are also shaped by them. There are many legends surrounding weapons and their owners. On Mount Song is a sacred site for Zen Buddhism and martial arts, Shaolin Temple. Many Kung Fu masters have honed their skills here.
Shaolin 棍施展性非常强，俗话讲就是说枪打一条线，棍打一壶片，比较刚猛。
云南松林火车站发生暴力恐怖案件，造成29人死亡，130多人受伤。
People have become more and more aware of the fight against terrorism in the world. Liang Jihong, a master of Shaolin stick skills, was invited to teach the Chinese Special Police Shaolin stick skills in June of 2015.
我的武术生涯中，以前是做教练，没有当过教官，这是我第一次，我感觉很光荣。当时公安的领导就说了一句：“你能为人民做点事儿。”我感觉这个荣誉太大了。我当时我确实是欣然接受。
A weapon is an extension of the human body. In China, sticks are regarded as the ancestor of all weapons. They are easy to find and rarely lethal, since they have no sharp edges. For this reason, sticks have become the most commonly used weapons in Shaolin Kung Fu.
In the more difficult places,棍对刀反复的这种演练，检验这些动作的实用性，就是说怎样使少林棍在这个实战中起到更好的作用。
Chinese people understand that sticks can be used to punish an opponent without killing him. In Liang Jihong's opinion, he and sticks both hate evil and never yield.For centuries, Shaolin monks have been subduing enemies, upholding justice, and protecting the nation with sticks. Today, this will be Liang Jihong's responsibility. Violent terrorist incidents today usually happen in public areas.Complicating terrorism prevention. Shaolin stick skills, which punish but do not kill, could take center stage in this effort. As soon as he arrives in Hulu Dao, Liang Jihong begins training the special police.
Shaolin Kung Fu 在这个现代社会起到了它应起的作用，确实感到很高兴。能做这一份工作，我感觉到一是荣幸，二是高兴。
It only takes a few months to master stick skills, but years to master blade skills, and a lifetime to master spear skills. The spear is truly the king of weapons.
一二，或者这样子，来，再来。
Chen Zhenfeng is a master of Shaolin 13 movement spear skills.Today, he's preparing to stage a drama featuring Chinese weapons, with the spear playing the leading role. Having the spear appear on the stage in the right position requires intense training of the actor. The Shaolin 13 movement spear skills are named after their 13 moves. It requires a fair amount of strength. After several hours of training, the actor is exhausted.
五岁半左右跟着我父亲开始习武的，我晚上也看过，他都在月光下练他的枪，很迅速，很猛。在我心目中，我很崇拜我父亲。
爹。
下饭，
都下饭，他咋么？
咱爹在那睡着呢。
你爹老带劲儿，心脏不要好。
也瘦啊。
瘦啊。
吃着也不中。
吃着也不中，那就臭屁臭味了。
Chen Jianfeng's father, Chen Wujing, used to be the spear king of Dongfeng City. An accident 8 years ago hit him hard, and he's not been the same since.
那咱是你的，你给你绝活得给我拿过来。
那枪哎，拿来。那枪。
那枪哎。
你去找找。
那我去找找。啊。俺爹枪。
不知道啊，这多少不练了，我也不知道怎么练出来。哎，你进去。
是该哪样
呢？你上哪样看看？咱哪样找找。
So that he wouldn't feel sad when he saw his old spears, his family hid them. Eventually, they forgot where they put them. As his son looks for his spear, Chen Wujing pulls himself up on the rope hanging from the roof. He wants to meet his old friend like a true Kung Fu master after 8 years since their last meeting. After searching every corner of his home, Chen Jianfeng finally finds the spears that his father once used to dominate the Kung Fu world. Unfortunately, the heads of the spears are covered with rust.
我动动动动这样动动背上，我背上枪亮起来以后，背后接着枪，这手双手这枪，枪我这在我那那一往那那一双，这手也我那接着，啪接着接，这手看着跟那枪头是差不多，但这是下的接着是，这手是这是双的，掐一双。这时候过来都接住了，接住就俩就这样。我这个意思就是大头啊，就是你表哥你妈。
那行吧，爹。让他歇歇吧。
我歇。
The former King of Spears officially bids goodbye to his precious weapon.Then he teaches his son the most important move, how to display the spear. After that, he'll wait to see the Shaolin 13 movement spear skills performed on the stage.
在船上都躺了六年，躺到船上，他还是在一直的说功夫功夫，叫我要好好给功夫练好。他自己起不来了，他把这个希望都寄托给我身上，所以我不会让他失望。
But in June 2015, Chen Wujing sadly passed away before the drama was staged. Chen Zhenfeng promised to do all he can to fulfill his father's wishes. Every day, Zheng Shuji begins his routine at 2 a.m. Traditional Kung Fu masters believe that practicing early in the morning is best for improving their skills.
两点多，在那个时候就起来了，很静。在这个时候是我的工作时间。
Zheng Shuji is 64 years old. His day-to-day schedule is different from most people. He never misses his daily Zen meditation in the mountains. Unlike most days, today he comes deep into the mountains after morning practice to carry out his big plan. Thank you. To other people, Zheng Shuji is just an odd, old resident of the town. But he doesn't care what other people think. He comes and goes and does whatever he feels. He lives in his own world. His real identity is that of a carpenter. Few people know that this Kung Fu master has had 5 passports and visited 46 different countries. These days he stays at home and focuses on making a Dharma rod, a sort of ceremonial adze or mattock, out of wood he found in the mountains.
道貌会长很巧妙，后世会长办公老，白天半军行百里，我与强盗当为马，做一拐又一拐，四面八方抢南来。他是专门打两边，因为这个行家呢，他都是走偏门的，所以说这专打行家。
宝儿，爷爷给你做了一个小打磨掌，从今天开始，爷爷就教你练打磨掌，和练功，给弟弟做一个榜样。
一、二、三，
哎，对，好。
叫你老头子，我要把这个东西，哎，留给我儿子啊，哎，留给我孙子呀。数年之后啊，哎，就是说我不在的时候，我的孙子会拿，哎呀，这是我爷爷给我造的，心情非常高兴啊，就是后继有人了。
一、二、三，好。
Wheat turns yellow in June in Hunan province on the central plains. Sui Zhongwu is busy harvesting wheat in the field with his son. A real Kung Fu master knows that both a rod and a sickle can be used as a weapon. Sui Zhongwu's father, Sui Shiqi, is also a Kung Fu master. His weapon of choice is a pair of elaborate double-bladed sickles. Now 93, he's been practicing Kung Fu for more than 70 years. In Dung Phung, almost all the legends about the sickle involve Sui Shiqi. As a special weapon of Shaolin Kung Fu, the sickle is famous for its sharpness and strength.
它这个需要一种合法和神法。The
sickle is both a farm tool and a weapon. In spite of being a Kung Fu master for 70 years, Sui Shiqi is always cautious. He believes there is danger in all weapons. The sharper the weapon, the more careful its owner should be. Being able to hold and release as needed is the most important virtue of Kung Fu practitioners.
这练武为了啥？不是为了门前背后三句话不成器，当官打他几拳都是真爱，这不对。练武是武的一切，一生很安全。
Fu practitioners describe the meteor hammer of Shaolin Temple as being swift as lightning and powerful as thunder. It always catches the enemy off guard.
柳青锤是软兵器的一种，它和其他兵器的最大不同就是能缠绕、能收放、能温藏、能圆、能紧。刚力带柔，柔力带刚，刚柔相济，收放自如，心想到哪里，手就走到哪里，力就用到哪里，锤就打到哪里。
Chen Tong Chuan is the head coach at a Kung Fu school. Hundreds of thousands of people now practice Kung Fu in Dung Phung. They have great respect for Shaolin Kung Fu. Several days ago, Chen's tutor, Hao Shijai, a great Kung Fu master, suddenly passed away, taking some of the skills to the grave. Chen must face this harsh reality.
我思想也很沉重。这些老拳师，有些会这么突然的离去，不但是他们走了，同时也把这些宝贵东西都带走了。在我们心目中，在我们眼里，他们永远都是强者。
Chen decides to begin visiting surviving masters of Shaolin Kung Fu, hoping to preserve their Kung Fu skills with his camera. Many older Kung Fu masters with ultimate skills want to withdraw from the world of martial arts, greatly saddening Chen.
<笑>有些一段时间都不了见了，你不知道他生命，他们的身体条件都咋样？体力，也跟不上。恐怕是跟不上。你要是说比比划划了，慢慢的你不要质量了，那我尊重也没事儿。我暂时想着你不搞就不搞，你搞你就是锤内心的性就到尽量在原有的条件上把它搞好，是吧？你练出来的东西，这一看，你最起码得想到没事儿吧，是吧？征集收集的时候遇到了不少困难，也遇到了不少阻碍。如果是把我们 老祖宗传下来的这种宝贝东西都把它丢掉了，我们没有给它继承好，没有把它发扬好，那是我们的罪过。我想，只要我有这个意志，有这个信念，我们都会一点一点把它克服。
Chen Tong Chuan has made up his mind. He decides to follow his heart and put his ideas into action. No matter how the times change, Kung Fu practitioners should persevere. They can't stop practicing, even if every
I'm now 并且还相连，用你的自己的行动，用你自己的表率，来感染你周围的人。
这武术这东西最讲究。
是真的假不了，是假的也真不了。行家伸伸手便知有没有啊。就拿韩天锦来说，
Wong Gan Chen hasn't had any customers during the past 20 days, but he still doesn't want to see his furnace fire go out for good.
构成一员虎将，无量比的一块差的太多，咱不说武艺高低。
Wong makes up his mind to create a traditional broadsword in the style of Shaolin Temple.
不但棍子被人家崩飞了，
Everything is ready, but Wong is somewhat confused. He's forgotten how to forge a broadsword. Wong sketches a broadsword from memory on paper. He's determined to make one that will reflect well on his craft. Forging a broadsword requires the concerted effort of two people. Wong's assistant has come to help him. Thirty years ago, Wong was still good at forging broadswords, and many Kung Fu practitioners had him forge broadswords for them. Wong is proud of this. After being beaten and heated many times, Wong's broadsword finally takes shape. Although the age of cold weapons is over, Wong still hopes his broadsword can ignite the passion of Kung Fu practitioners. No weapon is better than the human body. In Liu Gengjian's opinion, his arm is an ideal weapon. As a cook at a school in Dongfeng. Every day he cooks for more than 3,700 people, but no one knows that he's a master of iron arm skills. He practices his kung fu skills as he cuts vegetables, beats eggs, cooks vegetables, and kneads dough. After repeatedly tempering in the fire, the weapon returns to its original point, which is the human body. Portable and unnoticed, the human body is the most powerful weapon of all. Wong Zongren enjoys a very good reputation in Dongfeng. He's open and forthright, but he's been troubled by a problem for years. But what worries him more is a Japanese man named Satoshi Kawaguchi.
10
days from now, Satoshi Kawaguchi will come to Dongfeng for the 40th time. He's been learning Kung Fu from Wong for 20 years. But Wong hasn't decided whether or not to skills of the spring-autumn long-hilt broadsword skills.
Chief, 了多长时间能到东峰？
有半个多小时。
10 days later, Satoshi Kawaguchi arrives. This time he brings a gift for Wong. Early in the morning, Wong brings Kawaguchi to the mountaintop where he practices Kung Fu. He wants to give Kawaguchi a test to see whether he's qualified to learn how to use his beloved weapon.
I also know there are many people who say, Master, why do you call Japan's student? I also can feel it. But the Master himself, he never said that.
Wong believes that no other disciple could reach the level of Kawaguchi's Kung Fu. Wong has mixed feelings as he sees Kawaguchi's gradual progress. After a lot of thought, he finally reaches a decision.
Chanko, come in. You know who this side is? Kung Fu Shaolin is
who? I know. This is Guan Gong.
I learned the sword is 关老爷的大刀，可以称为关公大刀。哦，我练的这关公所穿的大刀就是代表和平。和平。啊，不是用来打仗的，打架的。
是。啊，
所以今天我带你来给关老爷上炷香。好，
是
拜一个。 关公这个大道，不是一般人都能学的。你要想学，你首先得去关公庙拜拜关公。嗯。 也是经关公批准了。我们的并不是哪一个人说了算，而是民族的一种精神在传播。日本的，你到中国也得拜关公。
The spring-autumn, long-hilt broadsword skills have been passed down as a symbol of loyalty and faith. They represent the Chinese people's tolerance and generosity. Wang finally feels relieved.
Back. 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 The Guan Gong's big sword is a symbol of national spirit, also a symbol of peace.通过陈国先学习这个，要传到日本去，要让他知道学着关公大道的深远意义。
最早来这里，目的是练武。现在到东方，感觉我回到老家一样。我师父给我起的中国名字叫王鹏礼，我师父王宗仁是我的中国的父亲。
Military force should only be used to maintain peace. Wang Zongren believes that there are no boundaries in the world of Kung Fu. Love is the most fundamental thing. Two months later, the first group of special policemen, trained by Liang Jihong, show up for work with their sticks.After recording the practice of older Kung Fu masters, Chen Tong Chuan returns to his school to use the video in teaching traditional Kung Fu skills. He believes legends will only survive if they are passed down to the next generation. Chen Chen Fung puts on his drama as scheduled. The Shaolin 13 movement spear skills are once again seen by the public.These powerful weapons are the continuation of generations of Kung Fu practitioners. In the next episode, we explore the world of the Jiang Hu, originally groups of men who had given up their worldly ambitions to dedicate themselves completely.To the practice of martial arts and pursuit of justice. Join us for part four of the Kung Fu Shaolin.
传说有绝学，深山藏秘籍。